Hey, Carrie.
Hi, John. How are you?
I am excellent. Where are we talking to you?
I'm Dorothy, Alberta, just a little north of Calgary.
Oh, very nice. Very good. Very, very
and
cool.
You were wonderful in Calgary, by the way. I came to see you.
Thank you so much. I really had a really nice time in Canada. I really, really had a nice time. I look forward to coming back there next year.
Well, that's great. I hope I can come see you.
Not with all that cold weather. I'm going to come, I think, in the warmer weather next
year. Yeah, it was kind of bad, wasn't it?
It was a little cold. It's a little cold, but you know what? It was all good. It was worth it. The folks were great.
Canada, really.
It was definitely Canada.
Yeah.
How can I help you tonight? Who are you hoping to connect with?
I don't know. This is such a surprise for me. I'm dealing with some elder parent issues and missing my father, who I haven't seen since I was 4 years old, and got anything for me?
Well, let me just say this. As I get into your energy, the first thing that I'm seeing is an aunt, actually. So I don't know if you have an aunt who's passed.
I'm sure.
If it's not an aunt, it might be a mother-in-law. Because is your mom still here?
My mom is still here, yes.
Okay. So if your mom is still here, this has to be like a mother-in-law or an aunt who's passed. This is somebody who's passed. So, and there's a C or K name I'm supposed to be talking about, either living or passed in the family. So I don't know if there's a Catherine or a Karen or a Kristen, but there's
a
C or a K sounding name.
K-A-Y-K.
Oh yeah, I'll never get that.
Kathleen.
In 26 years, I missed the name D. I missed the name J. I miss, and I'll miss K. So is she still here?
Yes.
Okay. Is she connected to the mother-in-law?
No.
Can I ask you what part of the family she's on?
She's my sister.
Okay. So is your dad passed?
Yes.
Oh, okay, you confused me in the beginning when you said you're dealing with elder issues. So your dad actually has passed.
My father has passed. It's
okay.
My stepfather that's having the elder issues.
Gotcha.
He's
okay.
Ill.
But now, is that stepfather her dad?
No.
Does he have children of his own?
No.
Okay, so he helped raise you guys?
Yes.
Okay, your father wants me to acknowledge that this man is your dad. Do you understand what I mean by that?
Yes.
Okay. Is there somebody in the family who either fixed mechanical things, so they were known for being Mr. Fix-It, or was he that person in life, your stepdad?
Yes. Yep.
Okay. And did somebody, and this is gonna sound like I just took a hard left, but did somebody blow up a building in your family?
Oh my.
Well, was there an explosion somewhere where you guys grew up blew up? Did somebody work for like a chemical company where maybe nobody passed, but it's like part of the history? I'm seeing this big boom, this big explosion.
Oh.
And it's funny, I was doing an event in California last week, and there was a gentleman that happened to be, I was in Los Angeles, in Hollywood, so let me just preface that, and there was a gentleman who happened to be there, and I was doing a reading, and I got a similar symbol, and I said, there's an arsonist in the family, and somebody said no, and we went back and forth, and I'm like, and he goes, well, you know, I am a movie producer and director and of action films, so, you know, I'm blowing stuff up all the time. He's like, that's production. And I went, no, in your world, that's production. In my world, you're an arsonist.
Yeah. Off the top of my head, but I did grow up in a lumber town, and they had what they call a beehive.
What is that?
And it glowed and burned all the time.
What is that?
It was where they burn all the sawdust and the shavings from the lumber
mill.
So
if I was to look from where you lived growing up, in the distance, I would see this glowing thing in the dark?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then that's my explosion, because I'm just seeing this thing. I wouldn't call it a beehive. I would call it a fire or an explosion.
Okay,
fire. Okay, that's kind of how it looks for me. And your dad is the one who's bringing this up. Now,
okay.
I don't know if you're one of four pregnancies and there's three kids, or if I'm supposed to say that out of the four in the family, three are similar, one is different. But I feel like there's something like that. And who has the M name, like Martin or Mart, Mark?
That's my stepfather.
Okay. This is just your dad's way of letting you know that he's around. Now, you said you're having issues with your stepfather, but there's also stuff going on with your mom's knees, right?
Yeah, my mom's knees?
Knees? Her leg or knee?
Leg, yeah.
Okay, because I'm seeing issues ambulating and getting around.
Yeah.
And I think that, is she a tough lady?
Oh, yes.
Okay, when I say she's a tough lady, I say it because I feel like she endures more than she probably should.
Oh, yes, yeah.
And she would rather not say something so she wouldn't be a burden?
Absolutely.
And somebody's got a unique name, like either Bertram or Bert or something with a unique B name. Barnum? There's a unique B name, unless it's a last name. Something with a Bernice? There's a unique name. Berta, Bertha? There's something like that your father's telling me to say. I don't know if he's talking about a person he's with or a person who's still here, but I want you to remember, like, I'll miss a name like Joe, but I won't miss a name like Cornelius. I'll miss a name like Jill, but I won't miss a name like Bertram. There's something that sounds like that, a unique B, like
I'll have to investigate that.
Bertrand, Bertram, Something that's got that kind of a sound, and all it is his way of acknowledging the person. So if they're passed, it's your dad's way of letting you know that they're there. Here's the most important message out of all of this stuff to validate it for you is just to let you know that you're not going it alone.
Right.
And that you should also ask for help. Do you know what I mean by that?
I do.
Okay. Because I feel like you're not, and he's making me feel like don't take it all upon yourself, even though you... It's kind of like when it comes to kids, if, you know, and I'm guilty of this, I admit it. My son's watching Go to Bed, Justin. But if for some reason, you know, he wants to go do something and it's, you know, we got to go to school, I'll say, let me do it. It'll be faster and quicker and we can, right? But it doesn't really...
Yeah, well, my mom actually just had I'm sure it was a visitation by my dad. He hugged her. He was so warm, she said, and he gave her a card.
A card?
That said, you had no dream. You had a visitation.
Wow, that is definitely a visitation.
Yeah,
well,
yeah.
Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to speak, and hopefully we'll get a chance to see each other in Canada next year.
Great.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.